gases and vapor are not very strong during volcanic activity. The ascending magmas don't erupt as lavas, rather, these are intruded below the crustal surface and after cooling and solidification, forms igneous rocks of several interesting forms. This cooling may take place either on the surface or while the lava is still in the crustal portion. Depending on the location of the cooling, igneous rocks are classified as volcanic rocks, cooling at the surface, plutonic rocks, cooling in the crust. Batholiths. A large body of magmatic material that cools and develops the form of large domes. They appear on the surface only after the denudational processes. They may cover large areas and that may be of several kilometers. Batholiths are granitic bodies, cooled portion of magma chambers. Laccoliths. These are large dome-shaped with a level base. Laccoliths is connected by a pipe-like conduit from magma chamber. It is located at deeper depths and regarded as the localized source of lava that finds its way to the surface. Lapolith, facolith, and sills. When the lava moves upwards, sometimes it may tend to move in a horizontal direction, wherever it finds some weak rock strata and form different forms. When it is developed into a saucer shape, it is called lapolith. A wavy mass of intrusive rocks found at synclines and anticline are called the facoliths. The horizontal bodies of the intrusive igneous rocks are called sill or sheet. The thinner ones are called sheets, while the thick horizontal deposits are known as sills. Dikes. When the lava solidifies in cracks and fissures perpendicular to the ground and develops a wall-like structure called dikes. These are the most common in Deccan traps. The width of the dikes can range from a centimeter to hundreds of meters.